stories do more than just entertain. They give us hope that anything is possible. And it is a lot of fun to cheer on the little guy. In many ways, 1 Samuel 16 is a Cinderella story. Here we have a literal lineup for God to select the next king of Israel through the prophet Samuel. The sons of Jesse line up and parade in front of Samuel. It's almost like a beauty pageant, and they're eager to be selected. In the end, the one chosen isn't even on the radar. He's the runt of the litter, the youngest boy, David, who has been relegated to the menial role of tending sheep. He's anointed by the Lord and filled with the Holy Spirit to lead. As we know, David becomes a mighty and powerful king, though not without considerable faults, like becoming an adulterer and a murderer when he gave in to temptation with Bathsheba. But history also remembers a man after God's own heart, a writer of Psalms, a shepherd king, a unifier of the northern and southern kingdoms, the one who prepared for the first temple, a man who wanted more than anything to follow God and care for God's people. David would become the most famous king in the history of Israel. His story dominates the next 55 chapters of the Bible. Our scripture today is a watershed moment in which much of Israel's history is put into motion, and it begins with an unlikely boy chosen for the most important role in the land. A Cinderella story at its best. And it won't be long, in the next chapter of 1 Samuel, in fact, that we learn just how mighty this young boy is as he steps into battle and defeats Goliath and the Philistines with a sling and a stone. In our Western society, we truly value outward appearances. People in America spend thousands and thousands of dollars on facelifts, Botox injections, tummy tucks, and various augmentations and reductions. We value our looks, and we value that first impression, whether it be a job interview or meeting a new neighbor. We worry about wrinkles, our weight, our hair, our nutrition, and if we exercise enough. Yet, what about the inside? I'm pretty sure we've all done it, judging a person from their outward appearance. It's like when you go into an expensive jewelry store and the salesperson completely ignores you because you're dressed a certain way, like you're dressed in jeans and a sweatshirt. The assumption is